This is a Sketchbox, I swear. I didn't just put a Sketchbox logo on an old Art Snacks box. What are you talking about? Okay, fine. It's a Sketchbox logo on an Art Snacks box. Welcome to No Box Art Box. This is the challenge where you replicate a subscription box without actually getting it. Do it for fun or for the challenge. Do it to try out subscription boxes before you commit. Do it to try out subscription boxes that you can't afford to try for real. Or do it to experience a past box that you can't backorder anymore. Lots of reasons to try it and have fun. Hello, and welcome back to Jenna Gets Creative. Today, we're replicating Sketchbox for March 2020, and I'm going to try to replicate the premium supplies as close as possible, but we'll run through what Basic got as well. If you want to try the No Box Art Box Challenge, the rules are simple. Pick any past art or craft subscription box, any box, from any month, as long as you're able to look up the contents that were sent. Match the contents as closely as possible using supplies you already own. Exact matches are fine as long as you're not using this challenge as an excuse to redo a box you actually got. If that's the case, match it with something else. Do the challenge! Make art using only these supplies, and if the original box had a challenge or a theme, try to stick to it. You can add missing essentials like paper or a pencil, but don't add anything that changes the game. If you want to share what you create, use the hashtag NoBoxArtBox, all one word, and if you upload to YouTube, feel free to also send me a message somewhere on social media to make sure I see it. I do curate a playlist here on YouTube of everyone's NoBox ArtBox videos, and it's quite helpful for everyone to be on the playlist, because playlists get about 50% more watch time than standalone videos. Sketchbox doesn't normally give us a prompt or a theme, so I'm just creating whatever I want using the supplies in this box. I've added a basic graphite pencil to do my initial sketch, but other than that, I'm using only the supplies I matched for the box, and I'm trying to use all the supplies I matched for the box. As per usual, I'll have a cost and subscription value slash savings breakdown for the original box in the description box down below, with prices in US dollars, Canadian dollars, and pounds sterling. I do this for my genuine unboxings and for my No Box Art Box videos to help you decide whether or not the actual box would have been worth it for you. All recipients of the March 2020 Sketchbox, both tiers, received an assortment of colored pencils, a blending pencil, a Tombow eraser, a double-hole manual sharpener, and a 20-pack of Strathmore 300 series artist tiles. These tiles are 4x4-inch squares of 270 GSM Bristol vellum paper. This is a thick, smooth paper with very little tooth. Generally, I see people use these for pen and ink doodles, such as Zentangle exercises and general mandalas, but I do know some colored pencil artists out there love Bristol vellum for their pencil work. Personally, I don't. I'd much rather use pencil on something with more tooth and reserve Bristol for marker and ink. But the box demands that we do pencil on Bristol, so that's what I'm going to do. I happen to have this 20-pack of Strathmore 200 series artist trading cards laying around, waiting to be used. These are 2.5x3.5-inch cards made of 260 GSM Bristol, so almost the same thing. For the pencils, the Basic Box is simpler, so I'll mention that first. Basic Box customers received a 12-set of pastel and neon shades of Spectrum Noir Color Blend pencils. This is an assortment of pinks, blues, and yellows, and would probably do great for a neon palette or highlighter challenge. Premium Box recipients got a mix of Chameleon, Tombow Erogitin, and Criticolor Megacolor pencils. First up was a 5-set of Chameleon double-ended pencils. These are wax-based colored pencils with complementary light and dark shades of the same color in each pencil. The original box sent 2 different blues, a green, a peach, and a white and cream pencil. I happen to have 3 of the 5 pencils from an old scrawler box, so I'll be using those. 601, 602 Soft Shell and Light Coral, 1301, 1302 Cobalt Blue and Midnight Blue, and 1701, 1702 Teal and Pine. For the others, I'll be matching using a couple blues and a white from my Faber-Castell Gold Faber collection, and a cream from Derwent Colorsoft. The Tombow Erogitin pencils were Silver Gray, Yolk Yellow, and Russet Brown, and I will be matching all 3 of these colors with Gold Faber pencils. The Criticolor Megacolor pencils were Ochre Light and English Red, and I will once again be color matching with gold Faber pencils. If you're wondering why I resorted to gold Faber so much, it's because they're a wax-based pencil, while my Faber-Castell Polychromos and my Derwent Lightfast pencils are oil-based. This box does include a blender pencil, which means I'll have to use it, and my blender pencil is a wax core, so I chose to use wax-based pencils only. Speaking of, premium box recipients got a 2-pack of Caran d'Ache Full Blender Bright pencils, and the basic box got a Prismacolor Premier colorless blender. I do not own the Caran d'Ache blender, so I'm going to go with the Prismacolor. Both tiers received a Tombow eraser, as I mentioned. The premium box got the Tombow Mono 510A Sand and Rubber Eraser, which features a gray sanded eraser for ink and colored pencil on one side, and a basic white rubber eraser on the other side. The basic box received a Tombow Mono Smart White Eraser. I happen to have a Tombow Mono 512A Sand Eraser, so I'll use that, and if I really need the white eraser option, I'll grab my trusty Tombow Mono Knock Stick Eraser. For the sharpeners, the premium box got the Criticolor Mega Duo Sharpener, and the basic box got the Spectrum Noir Twin Pencil Sharpener. I don't currently have any double-hole manual sharpeners, so I'll be using a pair of cheap plastic manual sharpeners in two different hole sizes. The Derwent ColorSoft pencil I'm using is wider, like the Criticolor pencils would be, so having the two hole sizes still makes sense. If you're attempting this box in particular, let me know what supplies you ended up using, and if you actually got the March 2020 sketchbox, I'd love to know what you thought of the real supplies. I decided to embrace the oddness of the color palette and go for a pop art inspired color combination and art style on a horse portrait. I tried my best to make sure every color had its moment, but I think the gray got absolutely buried and overpowered by everything else. The final piece has that typical grainy colored pencil look a lot of people associate with the lesser quality colored pencils, and that's because even though I used the blender pencil and tried my best to blend it well, this paper doesn't have enough tooth to hold all the pigment. Maybe I would get a different result if I blended with OMS, but that wasn't in the box, so we can't try it this time. Let me know what you think of the piece. Want more No Box Art Box? I've got the playlist and another video suggestion up on the left of your screen now. I upload art content for those who like to live life creatively, whatever that means for you, every Tuesday and Thursday. I've got a great video coming out on Thursday, so I hope you'll come back for that. Bye guys!